Yo, what up, y'all? Smagless Confetti, and you're now tuning in to Drop the Heat. And we here. Drop the Heat on a very special edition right here in Doobie Boy Studios. Yo, hold on. Who are you?
Smack, bro.
Smack certified, bro. Smack certified? What's good, my brother? What's going on, my G? How's everything? Yo, bro, I know you watched my interviews. Why you didn't know that was coming? I knew you knew that was coming,
I knew it was coming, but I didn't know you do it. Like, nigga, you ain't even warm up, bro.
Nah, I know, bro. I just, you know, gotta hop right in it, bro. It's the vibe, bro. Yo, I'm not gonna lie. Before we really dive into the questions, bro, you've been making music and dropping tapes since like 2016, bro. Like, it's been like 6 years.
I'm not gonna lie, 2016 was like the year I started like putting beats out. Like, I've been making beats before that, but yeah. I didn't really be putting shit out until I feel like I got like at least some type of music that niggas would fuck with. So it got to the point where everybody was like bumping shit, and then everybody was like, yo, this shit is fire. So I just felt like, you know?
Yo, how old are you, bro, if you don't mind me asking? 21?
Yeah.
So you've been making 21. So you was really like 14 years old, really fucking the streets up.
Because back then I used to make that double tap shit.
Yeah.
So it was facts. Back then, like when I first got my first computer, I tried to like make beats. But I remember the first thing I did, I tried to remake like Meek Mill. I'm a Boss or some shit like that. Like back then when all them shits was like beats like that. But then I shit ain't really go nowhere. So I made that double tap shit and niggas fucking with that shit.
Right, that's what's up. How did you grow your network with when it came to like being in the music scene in New York City? Because I know you had to go so face and network and meet different rappers. Meet, yo, my name is this. My name is, feel me, I do this. Like, that shit get annoying after a while, you feel me? But how was the process when you first started?
I'm going to be honest. When I first started, it was hard. But I ain't really look at it like, because I feel like there's like two lanes producers are going. Producers could go try to go strictly for like the main source or just like work their way around it and build up. I ain't really go for the main source because that was hard. Like, who DM in Future? You know what I'm saying? So I started with like local people in Queens, like started working with certain niggas. And then it got to the point everybody started realizing like I really make beats.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So after that, all like with Neek, people like Leaky G, like all that was just like mutual friends. Yeah. They just put me on. But other than that, that shit was hard, bro. Over time, that shit built, though. With New York, I feel like in New York itself, that shit is hard because it's like, everybody got ego problems. You know what
I'm saying? Working in Atlanta a lot now, like, presently, you feel me?
Yeah.
How is the difference from working over there and working over here? Like, how easy is it? Nothing's easy, but, like, how much more? Because I've heard stories that it's more settling to work over there with people.
Hell yeah. Like, I'm not going to lie. I've been in L.A. for, like, 3 months. L.A., you be in a room with niggas, you be in a room of five people, and you the fifth one, and all four of them will be millionaires, and you probably won't even have, like, $500, and they'll still treat you like you're a millionaire. Like, everybody in L.A. and, like, in the A, they just treat you the same, no matter what you got, no matter, you know what I'm saying? New York, you don't really feel that energy. Niggas only do that if you have something beneficial.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's how I feel. That's how it was in New York for me, but when I went to L.A. and the A, it was sweet, because then again, I was with Southside, you know what I'm saying? So, and then it got to the point, I wasn't really speaking much. But I was playing beats.
Yeah.
So over time, I kept on playing five beats, and the nigga just kept on like, what's your name? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, that's how me and Polo G, you had the interview. Mm-hmm. That's how me and him got a like good relationship over that. Like, okay. I was just playing harsh, and then me and him just got mad cool.
That's fire. That's OD fire. How did you and Southside get to meet? The question of all questions where everybody want to fucking know.
right before me and Southside met, I was working with one of my friends, Rameezy. He made music in Queens. Every day before that, we was going to the studio. Like, every single day, we was just recording him, picking beats, just recording him. And then one day, we went there on some fun shit. Like, I just ain't want to be in the house. So I was like, yo, we out to the studio. We was just chilling there. And then he was like, yo, look, one of my cousins, Frenchie be a son. He's like, one of my cousins went 808 Mafia Southside. I'm like, nigga, ask that nigga where he at.
I already know how that shit go, though.
I'm a producer, so that's the shit we do. Mm-hmm. Like, once we see, we just go through it. So, yeah, I hit him up. And then when he had hit him up, yeah, I told him, yo, we're going to be in quad. So, the first day, like, I ain't gonna lie, that whole shit was, like, a crazy process, bro. Like, the first day I went there, it was just, like, it was packed, nigga. It was D-Thing in there. Chef pulled up. Rod Switch pulled
nigga,
up.
Nigga, I think pulled up. G Herbo was there.
Hell yeah. G nigga, Herbo was there.
Yeah, I know. I was there that day, too.
That shit was crazy.
I was there that day, too. Mad, what funny shit?
I think Ron Suno was having a release party
he
upstairs
had a release
that
party
day.
Upstairs. Yeah, yeah. Capella had a mad. Capella had a yeah, session on top because yeah. I was in his
Dizzy.
Session.
I seen Dizzy.
Yeah, I was in his session. You feel me? Yeah. I know Chef had came upstairs to the shit.
That nigga got arrested.
Yo, I'm not gonna lie. That day, that was the day he got arrested.
Yeah, that's
crazy. I didn't even know that. Feel me? I left a little bit early.
Niggas heard like he got arrested.
But, shit, crazy.
Nigga, the first day I got there, I seen like I was just trying to like analyze the room.
Yeah.
Like, same shit I be saying.
Damn, why I ain't see you there, my nigga? I should. Nah. I feel you. I feel like fuck, my nigga. It's all good. But
nah, I ain't leave the room on Southside at all because it's like. Nigga, as a producer, that's some shit. That
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's a room that everybody want to be in. So it's just
yeah,
like,
you just stay.
You know
yeah.
what I'm saying? I was in like G Herbo.
And that was the first time. That was the first time you met Southside. You was in that session.
Yeah, first time ever.
That's fire.
Yeah,
I love the way.
So, goes. I ain't gonna lie, I was fake like nervous because it was just like nigga G Herbo rapping, Doughboy rapping.
Yeah, then, all these professional niggas in Southside. Nigga look mad scary with mad tats and shit.
But it's like
I know I'll be like what the fuck? Like I already know.
It just be mad niggas in there, bro. At that too, cause I ain't gonna. You seen how that shit was? Mad niggas in there, bro.
Yeah,
so
bro.
It's just like, I know. I know. I'm not the only one in here that's trying to do what I do.
Yeah.
There's really like two other producers in there, but at the same time, it was just like, I felt like, I was just analyzing the room. You know what I'm saying? And I realized somebody that I got cool with after that whole little week. Some Nick Slowburns. He make beats. He was playing beats, and I seen he was looking at the screen. So off rip, I seen that he was the one that was playing beats. So I just built it. I got a little drunk. I'm not going to lie. I took like 2 shots of Casa, bro. I got mad drunk.
Yeah.
I went over. I asked him, I'm like, yo, I could play beats. He was like, yo, after Nick played beats, you could play beats. I'm going to play like 3-4 more. I'm like, bet. Feel me? I felt good. And as soon as I went back in the room, whatever beat he was playing at that moment, Dobo you. So that, and then right after that, they left. So I was like, damn. But Southside ain't really like, you ain't paying me no mind. You know what I'm saying? Like regular shit. It's just mad niggas in here.
Yeah, yeah,
you feel me? The second day I pulled up now, that shit was crazy. Like, look, that was the day that shit happened. Like,
it's the drop right here, you
like
heard?
Like, the first day, they had left and went to Starless right after. And then they never came back, and I stayed in the studio. So the second day, he had left and went to Starless. So I'm on some, like, I might as well invite one of my friends. So one of my friends, Rico, he rapped. I had told him, yo, pull up. So when I went downstairs to go meet him, I see Doughboy looking out the window like this. I'm like, fuck, this shit about to get mad packed. So we just in the whole crowd.
Because he's always mad niggas. I already
mad
know.
Niggas, bro. And on top of that, 42 Doug was in New York at that time. He was recording like probably like 2 blocks down. So he put like the in front of crowd was crazy.
Yeah,
bro.
Blasto Studios.
Yeah,
bro, I was there that night too, bro.
What?
Yeah, yeah, I was in Penthouse and shit with the stars and
stuff. Yeah.
I was there.
Yeah, I only been there once. That shit's so fire. Mm-hmm. But long story short, but we just got upstairs. And then he was just playing pool. Like, he wasn't fucking with the studio.
Yeah.
He had these two people from Detroit, some niggas that be rapping. They was playing music off the aux. You feel me? One of my friends was like, yo, bro, just play beats, bro. Like, niggas trying to hear your beats. Like, remind you, there's nobody important in the room, though. It's just my mans.
Yeah.
I want some, like, I don't want to take a nigga aux. Like,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But you don't want to step on nobody's toes, yeah.
I asked him, I'm like, yo, fuck it. I'm like, y'all can play some beats? He was like, you make beats? I'm like, yeah. He's like, yo, sure, go ahead. Like, I play, like, 2-3 beats, but I'm the type of nigga once I start playing my beats, I don't play my beats for a purpose.
You know
what I'm saying? I really be playing the shit. So it got to get to the point I'm just in my zone. So I'm just playing beats. I play this one beat, bro. This nigga Southside just busting. Mind you, he's not in the room. He just bust in the room. He like, yo, what the fuck? You made those beats? I'm like, yeah. He was like, you asked me yesterday. Like, I'm like, yeah. He was like, nah, I keep playing more. So I'm playing more.
He said, you
more.
Want me?
You asked me to play beats yesterday.
Oh, okay.
Nothing. Like, his head was bust.
Yeah,
you walked in, his head was bust, bro.
Yeah.
So
I love that.
So after that, I was just playing more beats, and I'm on some just hype shit now. Like, the nigga just walked in and said, my beats is fire, bro.
Yeah.
Like, after that, just bumping. Everybody just came in the room now, because once Southside do something and say something, niggas going to try to see what's going
on. Yeah, that's a fact.
So everybody came in the room now. I'm just still looking forward, just bumping, because I'm playing beats for my purpose now. I just hear him, like, he's right behind me talking to somebody. He was like, yo, he dead came to me yesterday and tried to play beats, and then I fake just brushed him off, and he shits is hard as fuck. This is the hardest beats I ever heard.
Oh, my God.
Like, he was gassed.
He's gassing it, nigga. That's real straight facts,
like,
nigga.
I felt good, but this is why it was crazy. I turned around and laughed. He was talking to Offset the whole time. Offset was right behind me the whole time. I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
And rap, whatever beat I was playing at that time, Offset was like, yo, pull that shit up. Rapped on that shit, and then after you rapped on it, also just on something like, yo, how old are you? Like, 21. He was gassing me too. He was like, yo, bro, you an alien, bro. Give you like 6 months. I'm just laughing. Regular shit, bro, because it's the same day. I'm just laughing shit off. And then we was in quad for 5 days. That was the second day. Every day after that was just like, I was just feeling like Southside, bro. Like, everybody was fucking with me.
Yeah.
The second day, it was like, all right. You got to come in, like, you about to sign me. You know what I'm saying? Like, you came in, he was like, yo, come to my hotel the next morning. We're going to get your paperwork together. Da, da, da. He took my number the next day. He called me. He got family in Queens. So he had told me to link up in Queens. He was like 5 minutes away. And then me and him was just chilling. And then every day after that, bro, we went to quad. It was just like a different feeling. But now people asking me to play beats. Like, I ain't a. I'm in your face now. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know how you going quad? There's niggas downstairs.
You just say my name.
Once niggas said my name, bro, it's just like they valid. Like, before you had to say, oh, I'm with Frenchie. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I don't know.
By the second day, my niggas down. Coming for smack. Coming upstairs. That shit felt crazy. Nigga, I ain't sleep. I ain't gonna lie. From the second day, bro, I did not sleep.
Bro, that shit. Fuck your I did not sleep. Fucking, yo, my nigga, that's your dream, bro. You did it, nigga. You did that. You did that shit, bro. Congratulations, man.
Appreciate it.
When got me a little starstruck, I'm not even gonna lie. Yo, nah, the fucking story behind that is legendary. That's a legendary story, nigga. No cap. Yo, real quick, talk about what's the song that you produced for that's out right now that has a music video too. That you like and you be watching a lot.
I ain't gonna lie, some song Neek did with Sue Surf. Neek Bucks, Sue Surf, Demons, Sinning.
Yeah,
that video.
Neek Bucks who?
Neek Bucks.
Okay, copy. And what's the song called?
Demons, Sinning. That shit was hard as hell.
There's a music video?
Yeah, that shit's hard as fuck. The video is hard as fuck.
And what's the song called again?
Demons, Sinning.
Alright, so you already know what's going on. It's your boy Will Gates right here in Doobie Boys Studio. I got my boy Smack Certified to the right of me. We're gonna take a break and play that.
I don't know.
No, what's the name of that song?
Nah, it's Demon Sinning by Neek Bucks and Sue Surf.
And you already know what's going on. We'll be right back. Bow!
Half a million cash, that's just what I'm feeling like. Yeezy match my DR bag, that's just what I'm feeling like. Steady missing all my gas, so I ain't feeling right. We got soul ties, like I met you in a different light. I wouldn't lie to you. Swear if we locked